So when I was born, I had a disability in my ankles to where I would always trip and fall and not really be able to keep up with everyone else. It definitely made it to where I couldn't do as much as I felt I could.
What's interesting about Lucas, from the minute he walked in, he reminded me of my son.
I was definitely self-conscious about my feet because I felt like it was something that was dragging me down and keeping me back from who I really could be.
When I saw Lucas walk through the door, I knew I could help him. Lucas doesn't understand at this age how his deformity or his foot position and that need for correction would affect the rest of his life.
Like in elementary school, we would all play soccer and they would all be running for the ball and I wouldn't be able to because I would trip over even the smallest little things and get ridiculed.
I'm a father of five, happily married. When you live and you grow up in a small town, it's about that handshake, it's a communication with people. How would I want my children to be treated?
Dr. Jones is a very approachable and friendly person. It makes us feel a lot more comfortable.
I was able to come up with a plan for him to correct a pediatric dysfunctional flat foot, to align both the foot and ankle, which then will affect the entire extremity.
Methodist as a whole is definitely it's just a friendly place. You go in there and there's just friendly faces everywhere and they're ready to make it feel like more than just a hospital, make it feel like a second home.
Someone says, well, why would I not go to Chicago or a major university setting? Why would I not go to an urban center? And I look at a patient and I say, well, you have that in front of you. I bring downtown to your town. I like to work in a community setting. I like to bring university level care, university quality care to a community hospital. Why? Because the population, the community hospital deserves it. I don't think the patient should have to drive for several hours and wait in traffic when they can get that level of care right here in Northwest Indiana.
So now that I'm able to go back into that active lifestyle of running and jumping, and I'll go hang out with my friends and my neighbors and play, and I'll practice karate on my own, and I feel like I wouldn't have that opportunity if it wasn't for Dr. Jones.
I mean, I know he enjoys karate, and he can keep up, run with his friends, and feel normal.
Well, karate, I thought it was cool. I don't know, I thought it was cool because it was enhancing me physically with balance and just strength in general.
This should allow him to live a more functional life, to be a more active child. To be able to keep up with his friends, so to speak, and to be able to enjoy a more productive and active life.
Well, I haven't been in gym class for about 2 years because I definitely feel like one of the things that was making me not be interested in gym so much is not being able to participate in anything. When I was in gym previously, we would run laps around the gym, and I would always struggle and fall behind and not be able to keep up. But now that all this is done and I have that balance and everything back, I feel like now going into gym, I'd be able to participate a lot more in all the activities that we do.
It does affect the entire family, and especially when you want to focus on this child to bring him back to what's considered quote unquote normal, so that he is physically happy, that translates to emotional happiness.
I feel a lot better because I know that it's fixed now. He did a phenomenal job. I mean, I have two working feet now. I can run and do everything that I couldn't do with balance now.
Yeah, Lucas is just one of those kids. He reminds me of my son. I love having kids like this walk into my office. And when he comes in and we come up with a surgical plan and have this level of outcome and success, they walk away happy, and it makes me personally and professionally very satisfied.